If you want to record a podcast or an interview, often you will want to record in the highest possible audio quality format first, and then compress later. Recording to a compressed file can result in artifacting and noise, and while you might not hear it in the initial recording, it can definitely come up if you're applying any sort of post-processing to the audio or compressing it again for posting to a podcast host. But you probably want to record yourself and the person you're speaking with, or other sounds, to a separate track to mix together later on as well. Short of buying an expensive multi-track audio recorder like my Sound Devices Mix Pre 3, you need to use a software solution. But Audacity by default doesn't record system sound and microphone audio to separate tracks, and it's hard to find other software that will specifically do that. But I have finally found, or rather been pointed to by the developer of it in the OBS Discord server, a build of OBS called OBS Studio Multi-Channel that might solve this dilemma. While I wish OBS Studio could have an alternate audio mode where it records only audio and records multiple uncompressed wave audio tracks, this could be the next best thing. OBS Studio Multi-Channel is a build of OBS Studio that uses more updated FFmpeg libraries and enables multiple audio track recording for the custom output FFmpeg recording mode. This means you can tell it to use your normal X264 or NVENC or whatever video format and PCM wave audio and still have multiple tracks. In case you were unaware, normal OBS Studio only allows for a single track audio track to be recorded in the custom FFmpeg mode. So if you wish to record a podcast or an interview with uncompressed audio, download the OBS Studio MC installer from GitHub and install it. Now close whatever OBS it opens up. It opens up your normal OBS installation, not the new one for some reason. You have to go to C, Program Files, x86, OBS Studio MC, bin, 64-bit, and then run the OBS64EXE in that folder. Go ahead and make a shortcut to it if needed to be safe so you don't have to find that again. This launches the custom build. Now duplicate your normal user profile that you'd use in this scenario, give the new one a name like multi-channel or something, and then open up the settings. Go to Output, Recording, and now change Standard to Custom Output FFmpeg. Now things get a bit tricky here because you have to navigate the custom modes to recreate your normal video settings, that is if you care about how the video looks. I have attempted to remake my normal NVENC lossless recording mode with these settings here for you to compare, but if you don't care about the video at all, just set it to libx264, just kind of ignore the rest of the video settings. However, you will need to choose Matroska as your container format. This is MKV, as MP4 usually cannot hold multiple or wave audio streams in the first place. Under Audio Encoder, choose PCM S16LE. That is the normal uncompressed wave mode. Now you can check the different audio track boxes for the tracks that you wish to have recorded, and it will put them all in one MKV file. I also went ahead and put the audio bitrate to the maximum of 4096 just to be safe, but that should not affect anything for the PCM encoder, but might as well be safer than sorry anyway. Hit apply, and theoretically you should be good to go. Custom output mode can be confusing, and the support team generally doesn't support it, but it has been working so far for me, for this purpose. An issue that I have run into, however, is that you can't remux the MKV into a MP4. This turns out to be 0 bytes. This, I believe, is because the MP4 container can't hold wave audio tracks. In Premiere Pro CC 2018, as of the April update, you can just edit the MKV file itself and use Premiere to separate out the audio tracks. Otherwise, you have to get familiar with FFmpeg scripting to extract the individual audio tracks to separate wave files, which is up to you. This isn't the most elegant solution, but I do think it's a good option for those of you who just want to record multi-track wave or podcasts for podcasts or interviews. I would love to see a dedicated audio mode for OBS Studio, as listed in my 7 features I want in OBS Studio video, but for now, this is the closest we can get. If you like this video, you know what to do. Also, hit subscribe for more tech education and OBS tutorials like this one. I'm Eplesvox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and I will see you next time.